artist, I am Sfira, and I'm here to help you to become a full-time artist, right? Okay, what is a full-time artist? What do I mean with that? Okay, I'll tell you. Let's go.
Hi, I'm Sfira. I was born in an artistic family, and as an agent, manager, and producer, I've worked for many years selling artists from all around the world. Today, I want to help you to become a full-time artist.
Artist, I am Sfira, and I'm here to help you to become a full-time artist. To start, what is a full-time profession? Everyone can be full-time in almost any profession in the world. You can be a full-time lawyer, you can be a full-time dentist. So why you cannot be a full-time artist? I asked myself this a lot because it seems that society understands that our artists are huge, like Madonna, Beyoncé, or Andy Warhol, or Kubrick, or any of these people. They're like almost gods on earth that have so much money and have so much influence that they are way beyond mortals like us. Or you will start to death. I don't like this idea. They call it the starving artist, and I have a full video about this if you want to understand more about how this develop or why people think like that. But my point is that everyone can be a full-time artist. You can be an artist as a profession like you or any other thing in the world. I don't believe that you need to share your time between your passion and something that you pay your bills by the end of the month. You can have one profession, be an artist full-time, and pay for everything and be really active in society. And that's what I want. I want that more and more and more artists find this sweet spot where they can be themselves and they can do what they love to do, being artists. So how you become a full-time? Actually, you will need to understand that it's a path. You have a journey to go. And every time that you give a step, you go forward and you will evolve on this situation till you can become a full-time. Each step will give you something, but also will ask something from you. And everything that you receive or that you need to give are different in which one of the steps. Okay, maybe it's confusing, so let's explain it better. Let's pretend that you start right now and the only thing that you do is to draw illustrations when you have time because you love to do that. So maybe you are drawing in your free time and maybe you don't even sell anything. You don't see the value in that. It's just something that you do because you like to do it. So, in this case, what you have in your hands is a hobby. You're using art as a hobby. And that's okay, that's fine. Lots of people in the world do that. And you can stop right there if you prefer. You don't need to go forward and have this as a profession. For example, I love to decorate my house, but I will never be a architect, because this is not my profession. I like to do it as a hobby. The same way that I take care of my plants, the same way as I cook a fancy dinner once in a while. Those things are things that I like to do, but they are just hobbies. And maybe that's where you are right now. Okay, but let's say that you really love to do that and you started to invest more. So we start to learn better on how to do these illustrations. You start to find what your own style. You start to find your way as an artist. And when this thing happens, you create an identity. And the identity would be fundamental for you to go to your next step as an artist. This next step is that you're a sporadic artist. It means that you produce your art, you sell your art, but not in regular basis. You do that when you can do, and you sell when people like it. Usually your clients are your friends or your family, and you also are okay with that. as I said before about the hobby, you can do that once in a while. Maybe you decided that you're going to draw something to sell just on Christmas to have an extra money. Maybe you decided that what you're doing right now, you are going to do just on the weekends. And it means that you're investing more. Maybe it's not just a hobby anymore. You make some money already, but it's way slow and sporadic. So let's say that you say, no, I don't want to stay like a sporadic worker. I want to have this as my profession. How can I have this as my profession? Well, you don't need to have just your identity, but also you need to have some visibility. People need to see you more and more. You need to be appearing in places and attracting new people to look into your work. Maybe not just your friends and family anymore, but people that you don't know. When you start to have more visibility and people that you don't know start to get interested in your art and looking for you to commissions or going to be your clients, now maybe you are not just an sporadic one. You can be a successful part-time artist. And this is most of the artists that I work with. They are in this position. Maybe they already sell for some people. Maybe they have this clients or this fan base around them, but they cannot pay their bills. They still just make money as a part-time job. They still need to work on something else to pay the rent, to invest in the school for the children, to pay any other thing that we have in life. So how you can make this flip? Because the next step is being full-time. In this case, you will need some network. And when you invest in network, you start to get more space to distribute your art. So you see, if you go with me, you start as a hobby, you go to a sporadic artist, you become a successful part-time artist, before you become a full-time. Each one of these steps will have pros and cons and different challenges. That's why you need to change your mindset from each one of these steps. If you're in the real beginning, you need to create a very strong identity. You need to know who you are. You need to know what you're selling. You need to know for who you are selling this. If you already know this and you are selling your art as a sporadic artist, you need to develop your visibility to become a successful part-time. More people need to know about you. You need to have ads running. You need to go to interviews. You need to go your social media full of people. You need to have people looking to you and to your work. Oh, but if you already have the visibility, now the thing that you need to have is structure. If you don't have a structure to your business, you will not find the sweet spot that you need. You will find that you have lots of work to do and no result after that. And when you do have this structure, then you become a full-time. And you will rely on your network to have more and more work for the future, growth for your business, identity for what you do. Okay? So, first of all, I want you to understand where you are. Are you in the hobby part? You're your sporadic one? Maybe you're successful part-time? Or maybe you're already full-time, being just an artist, paying all your bills and being successful, helping the society, being just an artist and having this as your real profession. I really want to know where you are. Please let me hear in the comment section below. Next week, I come with more information on how you can become a successful full-time artist. See you next week. If you have some questions, put here in the comment section below. But maybe I can help you a little bit better, right? I have a free ebook in my website that will help you step by step. So So you can go here in the description of this video, so you can click there. Thank you so much for keeping doing art.